doing good at your place. Okay, so we welcome and came back again for the new with the new chapter, chapter number 1 of SS socio-religious reforms. In the sem 2 we have completed our chapter number 2 and 4. Okay, now the history part we are going to start chapter number 1, socio-religious reforms. Now the socio-religious reforms, reform means what? The customs, the systems which we are having in the like from the beginning. So some changes, so that is called reforms, some changes in that. And for the new century, what new things are going to be held and in which things we are going to do the changes, that is known as reforms. So reforms we are going to do in the manner of social and religious. Okay, reforms will be in the form of the social and the religion. It means the customs, the religions, the which we are seeing from the beginning. जो पीढ़ी दर पीढ़ी जो बहुत सारे social customs, old customs, जो पुराने रीति रिवाज चले आ रहे हैं. So we are going to see that in this chapter. कि like how we are our scholars, जो हमारे scholars हैं, जो leaders हैं, how they are making efforts to change this social religions. Okay, so first we will do the introduction part. That as you all were aware, in the 19th century, when the 19th century was going on, Britishers ruled over there in India. Okay, so in the 19th century, Indian society was infested with the social customs, the adult social customs. Means 19th century से और उससे पहले से ही इंडिया में social और रिलीजन के नाम पे बहुत सारी प्रथाएं चलती आ रही है, बहुत सारे सिस्टम्स चल रहे हैं विच इज़ नॉट गुड फॉर द पीपल. सो द सिस्टम्स आर लाइक सुपरसिशन, अंधविश्वास, इलिटरेसी अमंग द पीपल, इग्नोरेंस लाइक कास्ट सिस्टम, क्लास सिस्टम्स, इग्नोरेंस लाइक दैट विद द डिस्क्रिमिनेशन ऑफ डिफरेंट थिंग्स, एवरेज सोशल कस्टम्स, कास्ट and the woman conditions were worst at that time because they were not allowed woman to do something, to read something, or they were not giving the priority at that time to the woman. So the woman conditions were worst at that time. Priority, the jo woman rights hai, they were not giving to the woman. Okay, so somewhere the woman conditions were worst at that time. So how we are going to see that these kind of evil systems widespread through the 19th century. वो पूरा spread हो चुका था, not in the 19th century, means from the beginning only. हमारे forefathers से ही ये सारी प्रथाएं चलती आ रही है. So the customs spreaded like evil customs are female infanticide, दूध पीती प्रथा तो सबको ही पता है, and the child born, if the girl child is there, तो उसको गर्म गर्म दूध में डाल के मार देते, उनकी डेथ कर देते, तो that is called female infanticide. सती सिस्टम, अगर किसी का हस्बैंड के की डेथ हो जाती है तो उनके फ्यूनरल पे ही उन्हें जला दिया जाता है, that is called सती सिस्टम. and the denial of the widow remarriage, means widow को मैरिज के लिए मना कर देते हैं, like once अगर उनके हस्बैंड की डेथ हो जाती है, so again marriage is not allowed for the woman. and the second is child marriage, जो बचपन में ही बच्चों की शादी तय की जाती है. so all such things are the evil customs. okay, so as the western education, you are aware, we have studied in the sam 1 history chapters, the Britishers, they have tried a lot and they have spread of the English education also in India. So as the Western education came into India, so it was the new beginning, means we can say the new awakening for the Indian people. Okay, so Western education introduced a new awakening to remove all such this evil customs with the help of the different scholars. So first efforts was taken by the Raja Ram Mohan Roy. He was the first scholar person who has taken this reform. He thought he wants to change many things. Okay, so we are going to see what are, which were the people as a scholars, as a leaders, they have given their life for changing such evil customs. So we are going to study in this chapter first for the Raja Ram Mohan Roy. Then we will study about the Dayananda Saraswati and then Ramakrishna Paramhans and the Swami Vivekananda, what all four these have made the changes for the India. And afterwards we are going to see the reformation movement in the Muslim community, like how the Muslim community changed, usme kaun se changes aaye hain. Then in the Sikh and the Parsi community we are going to see. Then we are going to study about the Jyotiba Phule and the Thakkar Baba. See, as you are seeing that there are the many scholars and the leaders jiske bare mein hum log padhenge. Okay, so it means from this chapter you you will get the many short notes. Okay, so short notes can be asked also because many scholars and leaders are there who has given who has done many things for the India. So just go through these leaders and the scholars properly, and whatever I'm explaining, listen to that carefully. Now we will proceed with the Rajaram Mohan Roy. As I said, Rajaram Mohan Roy was among the first from all such scholars who has given his efforts and his life to change such evil customs. So he was born in 1772 CE in the Hooghly district in a Brahmin family of Bengal in Radhanagar village. Okay, and he also got married in the early childhood. जब वो छोटे ही थे तभी उनकी marriage हो गई थी. So his brother's wife in his family, his elder brother is also there and he was married too. So his brother's death, his brother's met with him death. Okay, so he saw that his brother's wife became a sati, means जब उनके भाई की death हो गई, on that funeral his wife became a sati, उसे सती बना दिया गया. उन्होंने ये सब चीज he have seen with his naked eyes. उन्होंने अपने आंखों के सामने ये सब चीज देखी, that how the woman become a sati. So that moment shook the Raja Ram Mohan Roy deeply. वो moment ने राजा राम रॉय को बहुत अंदर से deeply तोड़ दिया कि why such this evil customs जो हमारे रीति रिवाज चले आ रहे हैं, why people are continuing this, वो क्यों इस बारे में नहीं सोचते हैं. ओके, सो दिस थॉट केम इन द माइंड एंड ही थॉट दैट ही मेक इनिशिएटिव, ही टेक्स द इनिशिएटिव रिफॉर्म्स. उन्होंने फर्स्ट स्टेप लिया दैट हाउ ही इज गोइंग टू चेंज द थिंग्स, कैसे वो रिफॉर्म लाएंगे. एंड स्ट्रॉन्गली ही प्रोटेस्ट अगेंस्ट द एविल कस्टम्स दैट आई से child marriage, that sati pratha, doodh peeti, female infanticide and many more things which are problematic for the people. Okay, so he started the protest strongly against the social evil customs. So and soon he has started the newspaper, Bengali newspaper. The name is Samvat Kamuti. That newspaper he started in 1827 CE, means he has started writing the newspaper, and he has written the book of Mirat ul Akbar in the Persian language in 1822. Why he has written in the Persian language? Because at that time Mughal Sultanate was ruling over there. That's why he has written this book in the Persian language in 1822 CE. Okay. Then he has established the Brahmo Samaj. अब जैसे ये बहुत सारे चीज़ों को चेंज करने वाले हैं, रिफॉर्म्स लाने वाले हैं, सो देयर शुड बी एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, राइट, जैसे बहुत सारे लोग जुड़ेंगे उनके साथ और उनकी हेल्प करेंगे. सो ही स्टार्टेड द ब्रह्मो समाज इन 1828 CE. ही थॉट फॉर द स्टार्टिंग द ब्रह्मो समाज. एंड वॉट इज द ब्रह्मो समाज? इट्स अ बिग ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. That is established in the 1828 CE, and it is the mixed with the East and West values. East plus West. Now you will say, what is that East and West? The East, the systems which we are running from the beginning, and the West knowledge, which is foreign culture. बाहर से आइए. So as we have studied that Rajaram Mohan Roy has made the new awakening for the India, right? So the Brahmo Samaj is a mixture of East plus West. East values and the West side values both are mixed in the Brahmo Samaj. And there are the different levels, there are the different organizations which are there in the Brahmo Samaj. So you will that deeply you will study in the higher grades. So first I have given the introduction. Brahmo Samaj hai kya? Previously it was named as Brahma Samaj. Pehle uska naam ye tha. Brahmo Sabha, not Samaj. Pehle uska naam tha Sabha, and afterwards the renamed happened and the name given Brahmo Samaj, which we can say the God of society. Okay, so deeply you will study in the higher grades. So let's proceed. And after that, he has established a college, Hindu college in Kolkata, as was belonging in the from the Kolkata only. And he recommended, after that, as you all know, in the 19th century, British was ruling over there. Okay, unki government chal rahi thi. So he has recommended to the British government also many things where they should also take care for the public, for the welfare of the public. So the changes are independence of the press. Press ko independence di jaye ki bahut sari cheeze wo log newspaper mein publish kare, so that many things people can be aware. And the freedom of speech, har logo ko hak diya jaye bolne ka, they can be free to speak anything. Women's right, ladies ko apna adhikar diya jaye, women's should have their own right. Personal liberty, khud ki liberty honi chahiye. And the judiciary should be kept independent from the executives. Jo humne Supreme Court ke chapter mein bhi padha tha. Judiciary jo hai, hamesha independent rehni chahiye, taki agar koi aapke paas justice lene aata hai, to in that decision, not a single person or the powerful person can interfere. Okay, so these changes Raja Ram Mohan Roy has recommended to the British government. Okay, and he has also started the movement to abolish the sati system, as he has seen that sati pratha in his family only. So he thought that to abolish ki sati pratha ko hi mita dena ka hai. Okay, so he took the permission from the Britishers, means from the Governor General. He explained all such things about the sati system, and then Governor General has also passed a law in 1829. In 1829, Governor General passed a law. We have studied this sentence also in the previous chapters of the history in the Sam 1, that William Bentinck has passed a law for banning the sati pratha. Okay, so the Governor General was at the time William Bentinck, Lord William Bentinck. He has passed a law of to ban the sati pratha in 1829. After seeing all such things, then jaise ki वहाँ के लोगों ने, वहाँ की गवर्नमेंट ने देखा कि हाउ राजा राम मोहन रॉय डूइंग हिज वर्क, गिविंग हिज लाइफ टू द पीपल फॉर अगेंस्ट द सोशल कस्टम्स, कैसे वो लड़ रहे हैं कि ये रिफॉर्म्स उस इंडिया में आने चाहिए. आफ्टर सीइंग सच थिंग्स, दिल्ली एम्परर हैज टेकन डिसीजन दैट ही दैट टू सेंड हिम आउट ऑफ इंडिया, मीन्स इंग्लैंड, for his case of right to property. Delhi Emperor, वहाँ से decide किया गया कि उनकी property के लिए, उनका जो case चल रहा है वहाँ पे England में, उनकी property के लिए they should send to Raja Ram Mohan Roy, and he also accepted that thing and he went to the England. And in England, there only as he went, he never back again, because in England he died in the Bristol in year 1833 CE. जब वो इंग्लैंड में गए, he was living there in the Bristol में ही उनकी डेथ हो गई in 1833 CE. And what about the Brahmo Samaj? Yes, Brahmo Samaj के जो different organizations थे, the different scholars were taking care of that, and the Brahmo Samaj was played a vital role, बहुत important role play किया है for Indian society. Because he has abolished the rigid people, जो बहुत hard होते हैं, they are not accepting the टू एबोलिश द प्रथा विच वॉज गोइंग फ्रॉम द बिगनिंग. तो उन लोगों को उन्होंने सही रास्ते पे लाया, उनको समझाया. एंड द सुपरस्टिशन मीन्स द ब्लाइंड फेथ ऑन द रिलीजन, जो आप बिल्कुल ही सुपरस्टिशन पे बिलीव करते हैं, बिल्कुल ब्लाइंड फेथ होके जो जैसा बोलता है रिलीजन के लिए वैसा करते हैं, वो भी एबोलिश करवाया, मीन्स हटा दिया. सो ऑल सच थिंग्स राजा राम मोहन रॉय हैज मेड द चेंजेस फॉर द इंडिया एंड ही हैज गिवन हिज लाइफ फॉर चेंजिंग सच एविल कस्टम्स. और उनको और एक प्रथा तो उन्होंने एबोलिश ही कर दी, बिल्कुल हटाई दी, विच इज सती सिस्टम. सो राजा राम मोहन रॉय हैड मेड दिस रिफॉर्म्स फॉर द इंडिया. आई होप यू ऑल हैव अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट एंड द राजा राम मोहन रॉय. नेक्स्ट वी विल डू इन द नेक्स्ट, आई सेंड द नेक्स्ट वीडियोज एंड जस्ट गो थ्रू दिस वीडियो प्रॉपरली and the topic which I have explained, read from the textbook. Whatever doubts you will be having will solve in the lectures. Okay, till that time, take care and good day. Thank you.